With all that done, the first part of our Genshin Impact movement system is finalized. This took quite a lot longer than I expected it would, but I hope you were able to understand most of it without too much trouble. Of course, we still have two systems left to do, which are the gliding and the swimming systems. Thankfully, both use the movement system as their base, so they are not really very hard to create. However, I'll be placing this series into an halt for a while. Both systems do still need some fixing, as I've left them unfixed to be able to start the first part, but that's not really the reason why. The simple reasons for why it's coming to an halt are money and motivation. A little over a year ago, I got laid off from work and decided to try and get into game dev, and keep going if I was able to earn a somewhat good enough income within around a year. Unfortunately, the amount of money I'm making right now is 0 euros, which is the currency my country uses. For those who are interested, it roughly translates to $0. This is of course not sustainable, which means I can't really keep things the way they are, as otherwise I'll have to stop making videos, as I'll have to go find work and, well, work. Unfortunately, I can't really record audio after work hours, so doing both isn't very plausible, which means I will likely not do any more videos for a few years. Before that happens though, I'd like to try and earn some money through game dev, so I'm thinking on trying to make a few small games in hopes that it gets me some income. I do plan on finishing the series if everything goes well, but if things don't go well, then that will depend on how bad it went, but hopefully I'll be able to finish it up before I leave to work. I did think about a Patreon, but I know I won't get enough income with it to keep going, so I will still have to leave, which would make me feel like I was kind of scamming people, which I don't really enjoy the feeling, so I removed that consideration. Games are also what I'm mostly interested on, and that's what I wanted to focus myself on when I got into game dev. But in this a little over a year, I've mostly focused on tutorials, and not on making games. Which brings me to the second point of motivation. To be completely honest with you, I've been feeling quite unmotivated to edit videos, and I think I felt that in the last videos where I kinda just threw things around without caring too much, even if there were errors on the videos. I also started slacking quite a lot, and haven't slept very well for a while now, so I haven't really been enjoying these days. I will try to rest for a week or so and then likely try and make some small games to get my motivation up and hopefully get some income with it so that I can keep doing this. Because of that though, I won't be continuing with this series for a while, so our gliding and swimming systems won't be coming so soon. As a tip though, the main feature of the gliding is simply limiting the velocity much like we did for our falling state, but with a lower value. While swimming is mostly freezing your vertical position when you enter the water. I also added a GitHub repository where you can check the code we have done so far for our movement system. Of course, it does not contain the gliding and swimming systems code, as they aren't really fixed yet. I do apologize for this outcome, and I do hope that you can understand it. Regardless, I hope you have enjoyed this series so far and learned something new with it. The full video with the first part should also be coming somewhat soon. It's quite a long video to render, so it will very likely come with a lot of audio artifacts. So I apologize for that right now and hope that it doesn't come with any video artifact whatsoever. Until then though, see you in the next one.